the world.
Well, let's start not in Texas, but in Pennsylvania,
right.
Because as you begin the story, there's a personal connection
Absolutely,
to this that
sure.
you have that is the basis for at least the beginning of the story. It's about your parents
right.
and the trust that they're a part of and land in Pennsylvania that ultimately the rights are acquired. Talk a bit about that.
Well, this was land about 100 acres in north central Pennsylvania.
Yeah.
They bought in the early 70s with a group of friends. They created a trust, and it was, I grew up in Philadelphia. These were all friends from Philadelphia. This
right.
was a cheap place to go get some vacation,
right.
to get away from the city, to have their kids run around in the woods. And about 5 years after I started reporting on fracking, I get a call from my mother saying, you know, someone contacted us, a company called Chesapeake Energy, and they want to lease our land. They want to frack. What should we do? I mean, even to me, that was surprising how quickly this was spreading.
Right.
The Marcellus, which was this giant gas field in Pennsylvania, was really only in southwestern Pennsylvania by Pittsburgh. But it was spreading, and people were looking everywhere and leasing everywhere.
Yeah.
So then all of a sudden, this question, which as a reporter I had asked and traveled around and written articles about, became very personal. Because now it was my parents saying, well, right. what should
is
we do?
Is this a good idea?
This is a good idea.
And how do you make certain that your rights are being sold at the right amount?
Mm-hmm.
How do you put protections in place,
right?
So all these
exactly.
things become an issue.
Right. And so what I recommend to them, I said, look, this is going to be intrusive. When they build the well, that period of time, a few weeks, maybe 2 months,
right.
it's going to be loud, it's going to be noisy. But once that's over, it's not going to be the end of the world. However, you have to take steps to make sure this is done right.
Right.
You have to make sure that the water's protected, that the well is built right. And that's one thing that is so often forgotten. You mentioned before, we're drilling 100 wells a day. These are all wells that have to be properly built.
Right.
Because we're changing the energy world right now, but we really don't know yet whether we're going to look back in a generation with relief or regret that we did this.
Right.
There are questions out there. Look,
there are open questions as to the impact of all this activity, even this activity done properly.
I would think if you're doing this properly, if you're
right.
building the wells, if you're taking the right steps,
yeah.
fracking is ultimately something that is beneficial.
Right.
You're talking about, especially with natural gas, an efficient fuel, a low
yeah.
carbon fuel, and a fuel, frankly, that can pave the way for a renewable energy future.
Right.
Something that I think the majority of people agree with. However, there's no guarantee you're doing it right. There
yep.
needs to be a real focus and attention on how do we do this. And frankly, one of the things that really surprised me, 10 years into this fracking boom, you mentioned the public was just started becoming aware of it. The industry certainly knew about it. We're just now asking some of these really critical questions.
Fundamental,
Absolutely.
Basic questions.
Right. How much
right.
gas are we leaking, and is that bad for climate,
right.
Climate change? What can we do to protect the water?
What is the impact on drought-starved communities
mm-hmm.
like the state of Texas, which
right.
we know has just come out recently, the worst one-year drought in the history of the state? Is the use of water by energy companies as part of the fracking process ultimately a net negative?
Right.
right?
Well,
and
I think the answer there... Different
arguments on different sides about that.
I think the answer there is fairly clear,
yeah.
that when you're talking about energy production, yes, you use a lot of water to inject into the well, in
right.
fact, millions of gallons. But if you're looking at from the beginning to the end, from when you drill the well or dig up the coal to when you create the electricity, natural gas and fracking for natural gas is not a hugely, it doesn't use as much water as some of the other
energy sources. And a number of